So we need to acknowledge that, that it's okay to not be okay. It's okay to be aiming for good enough to try to get by. And that we struggle. But we also look at what else has 2020 taught us. We've seen a lot of altruism. We've seen a lot of people doing really, really good things, you know, for their family and their neighbors and, their colleagues and, their friends. We've also seen some tremendous advances in technology and doing things, whether it be healthcare or schooling or work, actually in new ways that we will carry with us into the future. So when we actually do look into the future, we do have to acknowledge that this has been a tough time on us and all of us in our community. It's important to have a positive outlook because just pay attention to what the brain is naturally hardwired to. Our brain is naturally hardwired to pay attention towards threat. I mean, that's actually super adaptive for our brain to do that. It helps with our survival mode. But what's been happening over the course of, 2020, it's just been one threat after another, after another, after another. So we actually have to work harder to shift that focus. And it's not trying to ignore the fact that we've had a lot of struggles and there's a lot of things that we're dealing with, but trying to maintain an upbeat, positive attitude is extremely important. You can be optimistic and you can also be realistic at the same time. One of the dubious things about when we become more anxious or more depressed is that tendency to withdraw, that tendency to pull back, or even changes in how we think, such as, you know what, it's never going to get any better, or why even bother reaching out? I'm, you know, not going to get any help anyway. So we want to make sure that we acknowledge that, but then battle against that. So always know that there is help to be had out there. Start off, whether it be with a close friend, family member that you trust, or if you've got a primary care provider, reach out to them as well too, and they can help in terms of air traffic control to get you connected to those resources, because that's the number one thing, is that there are treatments out there, treatments that are helpful.